Good morning to you from China. Talking about the word China, two things come to mind. First, the country, of course, where we are at right now. Specifically, we are in a city called Jinan in the eastern parts of the country, which is the provincial capital of a province called Shandong. Right here, we're seeing an expo featuring various kinds of items of China's intangible heritage is taking place. And second meaning when we talk about the word China is this porcelain. We had a look. We had just a little glimpse of the various vases and ceramics just now. They come in different colors and shapes, and they're really appealing to the eyes. I think the fact that the word China both means a country and a type of art just goes to say that art and culture is very much intertwined with the history and current state of a country. So I think a lot of a country's culture and history and aesthetics can be seen in the country's various types of art. And intangible cultural heritage is really art in its highest form, craftsmanship in its highest form. So today in this expo, we are going to take a tour in this very huge expo. We're going to see different kinds of art items, cultural items. We're going to see craftsmanship at its best. We're gonna go check out a couple of the country's top, we call them inheritors of the country's intangible cultural heritage. It's a bit awkward, a bit windy name for a craftsman, but basically it means the person who's really the best at this kind of craft and who is who took over the craft from their predecessors and are tasked with promoting and passing down this kind of craft. A lot of them are disappearing, to be honest, but we're going to see them, and we're going to see how some people are doing all they can to preserve art forms and craftsmanship. So this is our first station. We can see there are different stands organized by different categories in this expo, and we're going to check out a couple of them today, but this is our first stop. And this is, let me just first of all explain what this is, because it's a bit, just a bit complicated, so bear with me. This is called liaoqi, and it's an art form from Beijing. So liaoqi is basically the top form of a material called liuli, which is basically glass with metallic elements in it, so they take on different colors. So basically liaoqi equals a kind of glassware. So this auntie, in Chinese we call people auntie and uncles just to be intimate, and this auntie here, we had a chat with her just a little bit earlier, and she's a national level inheritor of the liaoqi making craft. And we can see it's a very busy stand right now, because when they promote these items, this expo also allows these inheritors of a cultural heritage to sell their items. So we can see it's early in the morning. It's 10:30, about 10:30 Beijing time, and it's a weekend. It's Sunday, so we're seeing a lot of customers are coming to this expo, checking out the various forms of art and craft items, and we're seeing a lot of parents are taking their children. We're seeing a lot of students here today. So. Very busy stand. We're going to see if Auntie Xing is going to have a moment to talk to us. Xing 阿姨，我们来了。先给我们大致介绍一下您这个摊上都是什么，行吗？
我们是北京料器，它有700年的历史。它是呢，康熙年间成立造办处，原来是专门给皇宫御用。不许老百姓用。
So
出来比金子和玉都贵。
So 安琪邢阿姨，您名字叫什么？先给我们做。
叫邢兰香。
Miss 邢兰香 ，She just told us that this is a type of craft that's got over 700 years of history, and during the Qing Dynasty, this is a kind of a cultural art item solely reserved for the royal court. So civilians and plebs are forget about it. They're not allowed to own these, make these, have these. 所以那邢阿姨，您做料器有多少年了？
我五十多年了，我62年嘛，都五十多年，17岁就干这个。我现在是第6代国家级代表性传承人。
邢阿姨 started making 料器 ever since she was 17, so more than 50 years now. And now she's one of the top 料器 makers in China. And like I said before, a national level inheritor of this kind of craft. 邢阿姨，今天有什么能展示给我们看一下的吗？我知道就是
这工具啊，就是一把镊子，就像这个就是，然后这做这原材料，就是在热熔以后呢，就用这一把镊子塑形。就像那个
这些 ，these are raw material，
原材料，
就是这些就是琉璃，对不对？
料器，
料器
没有这原材料。
料器是和琉璃的关系是
不一样。这是据说是乾隆给起的，说这料呢叫官料，叫御用的料，做出这东西呢叫器，说叫料器吧，有700年的名称。
So this is a material that we call 料, which incidentally also means material. And 器 is basically, 器 basically refers to these items. We can see they are really, really shiny and really comes in different types of colors and shapes.
料的品种特别多，你看这叫摆件，这叫挂件，是吧？什么都可以做，因为它就是没有模具，全凭手工。是比较难的一个工艺。
邢阿姨 said the craft of making 料器 is very difficult because you don't have a mold to shape these materials. Everything you melt these materials on fire, which we are going to see on this screen. And here I want to apologize to our audience because fire is not allowed in this expo, in this venue, so we can't have 廖阿姨 demonstrate every single procedure of the 料器 making process to us today, but a lot of it we can see in just a little bit on this television screen, and 邢阿姨 is definitely going to give us a little taste of what 料器 making is all about, so just bear with us. So I was just explaining that 邢阿姨 just said 料器 making is very difficult because you melt these material with fire and everything is in your head, basically. You don't have a mold, you don't have a model, anything is possible. So that makes this craft very difficult, but I guess it also makes it very interesting because anything is possible. There's no rules to follow.So we're seeing on this television screen.
对，这就是制作的过程。这一把喷灯，这烧化了，就这一把镊子。你看，就做出，随便做，就这一把镊子。
With this fire, you melt the glass, and then once it becomes soft, once it melts, you basically can shape it, can mold it into all types of shapes and forms.Wow, this is very interesting. 这个做的是什么？
老虎。
This is a little tiger. You see, this is the final product here. Oh, that's so cute. 小老虎。阿姨，那个今天有什么可以给我们展示一下的？
我们这因为品种比较多，像这个我呢就是给你展示做花儿。像这个品种吧，像这个这叶子吧，都是这么做出来的，一个一个花瓣。这叫花心儿，这也
是。This is what. 这
叫花心
儿。This is what 邢阿姨 is going to show us today. She's gonna make these flowers, and you can see this petal of this petal. She already molded this after she melted the glass in advance. So we're seeing it's almost translucent. You see. How many petals? 有几片花瓣？
就弄出一朵花儿，就是这是简单的。你搁要攒大朵花呢，就是多点花瓣。这就是一简单的五瓣花，这叫玛瑙色。
So for the sake of time, she's gonna show us something that's quite simple today. A flower with only 5 petals, but she can make things much bigger if she's got the time.
这料器啊，它像特跟那个玉器比的颜色。有的比玉还好看，都是按那个 A 级的玉啊配置。你看这叫岫岩玉，这叫鸡油黄，这个是祖母绿，这个是珊瑚红，都特别。
这个也不是玉，
这岫玉。
叫岫玉。
岫玉的料器，你按那个 真正好的绣玉的那个，先化验它的成本，根据它那成分，然后按 A 级货，所以它的比那个真的还好看，它按最好的玉色配的。
你看这就是玛瑙色，
多漂亮！啊，
是
是。
是吗？
对，这叫老寿星。
It's the god of longevity in China. And we can see it's really very beautiful material. This 一个得挺贵的吧？
这，现在我们卖的不贵啊。按说应该这属于收藏的了。这里有银子，没有银子不出这色儿。这都几
是。That's why it takes on this kind of color. Otherwise, it would have been impossible for it to take on this kind of color. So this should be quite expensive. This is for a collection, not just for ordinary decoration.
然后这个呢，就是象牙色。
啊，
这叫象牙。
Quite ivory kind of color. 这个里面是加了什么？
那我就不知道，我就知道那贵重的。像这是八种姿势，叫八马。这是大公鸡，就是一套公鸡、母鸡和小鸡。
So you can really make it big and small. We're seeing, the big chicks here and their chicklings here. 所以他，您做的这个是父母带着五个小宝宝，
对。
Parents with their five babies.
对对对。
您这活儿做完了吗？
基本上就走那个叶子。
We're putting on the last piece of petal, and we're gonna put it together.
然后就是好多花呢，就组织一起呢，就是盆花啊、插花。你看，这特别结实，不过运输也不碍事。你看，你随便掰，你看，就是简单的一朵花。
She says this is a simple kind of flower.That she makes, but if you have a lot of these, then you can make a bouquet. If you put it in a vase, it should be quite beautiful. And she said the material is very durable. Actually, you can ship this, transport this to different places, and it just doesn't come off. 真好看，行啊！您当时是怎么就做上料器的呢？
我当时毕业以后也不知道参加什么工作行，完了就是填一个服从分配。然后被那个料理厂啊，就是挑上了，就一直就干到现在，没改过行，干了一辈子。因为这料理是最难的一行，因为它没有模具。你看那个刚才也说了，它就是一把这镊子，你想要什么做什么。你没有几十年的那个功夫啊，练不出一个好的灯工。因为你要什么做什么，这积累经验丰富，那五十几年了干，才能达到那个随心所欲，你要什么做什么。没有几十年功夫不成。
邢阿姨 said, she, after middle school graduation, she started working in a glassware factory, and that's how she got her start in 料器 making. She reiterated again that it's a very difficult craft. As you can see, this is the only tool that you have once you melt the glass. So every shape that you want to mold the glass into, you do it with this single tool. So Xing Ayi has been in this trade for more than 50 years, and that's why she said she can do whatever she wants with the material in her hand. And she said this is really a craft that takes time and practice and experience. 那所以说现在的年轻人，您觉得这
因为一般他这个很艰苦，夏天特别热，而且别人帮不上忙，还有一个时间限制。因为你慢了以后它就凉了，你拽不出来了，在火里头你快了你没弄出来，所以是特别难的一行。你所以现在的年轻人呀，反正坐得住的比较少，就是比较艰苦。
She said another reason why this craft is so difficult is because of the difficulty in timing. Because once you melt the glass, then you have to mold it in a very specific kind of in a very specific window of time. Because if you do it too fast, then you can't shape it into the kind of shape that you want. But if you do it too slow, then the glass hardens and there's nothing you can do about it anymore. So this is another reason why this craft is so difficult and is also quite.Hot in the summer. So she, again, she's been in this practice for more than 50 years, and she said fewer and fewer people, especially young people, are practicing it today because it is a very energy consuming, mind consuming, and a very tough kind of art. She said there's gold in this, and the color never comes off. It lasts for thousands of years, and the color won't come off, she said. In traditional Chinese culture, this is a longevity peach. 好嘞，邢阿姨，我们再转悠转悠，谢谢您，邢阿姨。哎，好。I could stay here forever. This is just so interesting. And you're seeing there are so many people here in this venue. In Chinese, we call it 摩肩接踵, which means shoulder against shoulder, foot after foot. It's a kind of idiom used to describe just how many people there are in this venue.This is a quite huge venue. We are on the second floor right now, and in just a moment, we're gonna go to the first floor to check out something more interesting. But along the way, you can see different types of clay pots. These ones are quite traditional. And also teapots.Traditional ancient Chinese literatis used to say, I'm just going to say this in Chinese first to help me translate. 宁可三日无肉不可一日无茶. So we can go 3 days without meat, but not 1 day without tea. So just goes to show the importance of the tea culture in traditional Chinese culture. We're also seeing clay pots.In different shapes and forms. These ones are black and therefore carries quite significant gravita. And we are moving on to the next hall here. As I said just a little bit earlier, this expo, this exhibition is organized according to different categories, and this is a quite different category of craftsmanship.And again, so many people in this hall. This hall features weaving, not weaving in the sense of cloth making, but different types of basket weaving, straw weaving. We're seeing different products right here. Straw vases, straw baskets. And they may look quite similar.But they have a very different kind of making process because the materials are also very different. For example, this one is called liu. Bian liu means liu, it's willow. So these ones are made out of willow branches, and we're seeing this craftsman at the very beginning of making something.老师，您这是做什么呢？啊，
小葫芦。
啊、oh, ，This is what he's making. So here they're demonstrating. 谢谢您啊 ，They're demonstrating something quite small and quite simple. But if they have more time and more space, they can really make something.That's quite practical and aesthetically beautiful as well, like these baskets. A very bustling venue right here on this side. We're hearing some music. I think some kind of show is on play here. a lot of people are gathering here to... Yes, there is a small stage here. We're going to see if we can... I think it's just ended. Yes, but it is a very traditional kind of Chinese drama show, and we can still get a glimpse of the actors and actresses here in very traditional Chinese garment and Chinese makeup. And there's another bigger stage downstairs. I was very worried yesterday that the sound from these drama shows, these theatrical performances are going to affect our audio. But so far, so good, eh? Moving on. For those of you who just tuned in, we are now in eastern China's Shandong province in its provincial capital called Jinan. Here, an expo is taking place featuring some of China's best items of its intangible cultural heritage and some of the best craftsmen, inheritors, makers, purveyors, promoters of these intangible cultural heritages. And we are right about going to the brightest and more colorful hall in this exhibition. But just before that, just see this straw-weaved dragon head. We all know that dragon is a mythical creature in the Chinese culture, which symbolizes prosperity, auspice. And this is a dragon head made out of straw, out of grass. Alrighty. I'm getting the sense that my cameraman really wants to film everything, because this is quite sensational. I was talking to the chief planner of this expo the other day, and he was telling me that he hoped that this venue could appeal to people's every sense. So downstairs, there's tea making, alcohol making, and right here you can see this is really the most colorful and the brightest hall in this entire venue. We're seeing a lot of lanterns. We're seeing lanterns, umbrellas on the ceiling, which we're going to get to in just a little moment. But first of all, just look at these lanterns. Endless sizes, colors, shapes, endless possibilities. And here again, I think we're seeing a fish with the dragon head. In traditional Chinese culture, they're both symbols of auspice. Some of these lanterns are quite simple, and others are quite elaborate. This one is in the shape of a pagoda. Quite sophisticated. Lanterns carry significance in traditional Chinese culture because the most traditional lanterns are in a round shape. And circles in Chinese culture is a symbol of reunion, of getting together. We know that on the 15th day after each Lunar New Year, Chinese people celebrate the Lantern Festival. Traditionally, in ancient China, that's when people would come to the street to see different lanterns lit to ring in the new year. It's very hard to find my cameraman behind me. And we talked about how circles are symbols of reunion and getting together, and therefore umbrellas. Umbrellas are also a symbol of romance in traditional Chinese culture. Quite poetic, actually. And we're going to come and see. Wow, Wow, we got really lucky. I think this gentleman here is painting an umbrella here. Mr. 毕六福，毕老师，
我们来了哈。
啊，行行行。
现在是干嘛呢？
现在是福祉。
Oh, she's going to put these paper. These umbrellas are not just traditional, not just your everyday umbrellas. They're called oil paper umbrellas. So like its name suggests, they're made out of paper and oil.
毕老师给我们介绍一下这个油纸伞，特别是外国的观众可能不太知道，觉得这个纸怎么可能做伞？
我是不是说中文了？
啊，说中文没问题。
四川话都没有问题吗？
四川话都没有问题，我给您翻译。
啊，因为我们的油纸伞是这个2000多年前呢，我们的祖宗就发明了呢，听得懂吗？
听得懂。He said our ancestors invented these umbrellas 2,000 years ago, more than 2,000.
因为这个非物质文化遗产本来就是我们祖宗，也不是某一个人的，是我们祖宗传下来一种瑰宝，所以我是国家级的油纸伞制作传承人。我更有这个责任，把我们的这个油纸伞技艺在现场展示跟我们的外国朋友和山东的全国的这个观众。
He said he's quite happy to be live streaming to you right now because this is not his craft, but a kind of craft passed down to him from ancestors from 2,000 years ago. So he feels proud, quite proud to be a oil paper umbrella craftsman. And he's indeed also, like we said before, a national level inheritor of this kind of oil paper umbrella making craft.
所以毕老师现在您继续工作，给我们展示一下您的这个做伞的工艺。
现在我展示这个技艺叫做表背纸，就是我们的是每把伞的时候它有接头的，就是要每个缝口都要把它接好，把这个伞要表示浑平舒适，要抬这个抬，特别是这个花色平均要接好，要好看。
He's right now pasting the papers to the umbrella ribs, and he said this is a quite tricky part as you have to.Because this umbrella is made of different pieces of paper, so he said the tricky part is to connect these pieces well, so the pattern won't be disrupted. I'm just gonna give you a moment to take in what Master B is doing here.So let me just give you a little bit of a craft lesson on oil paper umbrella making. So you may wonder, especially those of you from outside of China, how paper can be used to make umbrellas. So this is a very special type of paper that's on some level waterproof, because this is a paper that's made from tree bark.And then why is it called oil paper umbrella is because makers of this kind of umbrellas are going to then brush a type of oil on top of the paper to make it waterproof. And this type of oil is extract from the fruit of a type of tree called the tong tree. That's how you make it waterproof. And, if we just take a look at the Chinese introduction on this board here, according to this introduction, these umbrellas can withstand 9,000 times of opening and closing, and you can soak it in water for 24 hours without destroying it.
没有，您再弄一会儿，我们看看。这个技术难吗，毕老师？您觉得？
难啊，我们讲究的是就是。一把伞的话，它我们的接头都是在这个伞柜上。
嗯，这还是挺耐用的哈。
我把衣服也提上了嘛，这舒服起来，这展示这个技艺。
He's gonna put on the last piece。那这个画也是您要自己画上去？
画有手工绘画了，有石版印刷了。
您就只负责造伞。
对对对。
绘画您不管？
绘画是专门我儿子们他也会。
He's only in charge of umbrellas making, not in charge of painting the patterns onto the umbrellas. Which he said is already quite hard, only the umbrella making part. So Mr. B is from a city called Luzhou in southwest China's Sichuan province. And that city might well be one of the last places that is still making these kind of oil paper umbrellas on a large scale. And as I said before, umbrellas are really a symbol of romance in traditional Chinese culture. So there are a lot of plays, dramas, poems, which feature umbrellas in it. So that's why I think walking into this particular hall with all these umbrellas on top of the ceiling, it really creates a very romantic atmosphere. 哎，毕老师可以了，谢谢您啊。Just saying thank you to Master B. Liu Fu, and we are going to move on to something else. Really crowded venue. Parents taking their baby here. How come, ma? How come, ma? Shy boy. 带孩子来看看展哈，
对对，
现在看得懂吗？
看不懂。
this boy's parents are saying that they want the boy to be exposed to culture from as early as possible. Many small children, many parents taking their children to this venue today. Some of our audience members are asking where we're from. 老师，我们是那个中央电视台的中国国际电视台，我们是。对对对 ，CGTN。A very friendly crowd. And we are going to go down to the first floor. I know there are so many things that we didn't see on the second floor. And you probably feel that that's such a shame, but I promise you there will be something exciting and beautiful waiting for us down on the first floor. So just bear with me.As we thrust our way through the crowd on the escalator. Okay, so as we go down to the first floor, if we can just have a bird's eye view of the entire venue,罗哥扫一下这边 Like I said, a huge venue. This expo takes place every year, and this is the fifth year in a row now. And I told you earlier that I was talking to the chief planner of this event 2 days ago, and he said that through these... items, through these intangible cultural heritage items, we're really seeing tradition and novelty, familiarity and strangeness in the Chinese culture. And he said the accumulation of these arts, of these fashion items, is what makes classics, it's what makes masterpieces.And so right now, we are going to the hall which features the art of weaving, cloth making, different types of cloth making techniques. So weaving, embroidery, what else? Dyeing. And this is also one of my favorite halls, just because you can seeSo many endless colors, textures, patterns from various historical periods, from various ethnicities, and we're seeing this girl right here is wearing a silver headwear, which is quite exotic. And she's from the Miao ethnicity, from southwest China's Guizhou province. And this particular kiosk features the Miao embroidery. Very colorful clothes. I always feel like that some of the ethnic minorities in China have some of the world's best garment. Just so colorful. And wow. On this stage, we're seeing models wearing different clothes, Chinese clothes from different regions and different time periods. Displaying to our audience the beauty of art and the beauty of femininity. Guess we're just gonna linger here for a little while. I'm just taking a look here. I think some of them are wedding dresses, like that one over here. That one over here.
那个婚礼的衣服吗?
I accidentally took the wrong turn. I think my cameraman just got stuck in the crowd.
需要我帮你一下吗?
I accidentally took the wrong turn. So we're gonna take a detour. And I didn't see this the other day, but I think this is a type of music from southern China. Yes, Suzhou Pingtan, from Suzhou in eastern China's Jiangsu province. Are they going to continue? Wow. You might recognize this song, one of the most classic pieces of Chinese music, called Mo Li Hua. So she's singing about the jasmine flower here. So I'm looking at the introduction here, and it says that artists typically play the pipa, which is this kind of musical instrument, and sings along. And the content of this kind of music, which is called Suzhou Pingtan, mostly features romance stories and folk stories. Wow, and this is also a national level intangible cultural heritage. But I'm afraid we have to move on. Okay, I did take the wrong turn, so we're just going to quickly go back to the right spot. I apologize, just so many people here. And husbands taking pictures of their wives, really appealing to the eyes. I was telling my friends that this is a really dazzling expo, because I think the nature of intangible cultural heritage is that they never fail to capture eyes, capture attention. In other halls, there's also wood carving, traditional Chinese ink, and brush pen making. This is where I hit supposed to turn. Like I said, a little I'm sorry, a little recap here. We are in a expo that features some of China's intangible cultural heritage items, and their respective craftsmen in eastern China's Shandong province in its provincial capital called Jinan. And I'm really excited about what I'm about to show you right now, but first of all, let me just make sure that my cameraman is following because it is a very crowded venue. And we're approaching it. As we approach it, we're seeing that this is a giant wooden machine in front of us, which looks like a loom. But it's probably not a loom because it's so huge. Right now I'm telling you, this is the king of all looms. It's called a two-level flower loom. And it takes two people to operate it. And this is also one of the most crowded, most popular stands in this venue. We're seeing the king's dress here, if you recognize it, if you recognize the color, yellow, which is a color for royalty, and also the dragon on the chest of this piece of garment. It's also a animal which symbolizes royalty. And just first of all, let me give you a little bit of a background information on what we're seeing right now. We're seeing the yunjing technique. Yunjing means cloud brocade, so-called because of its cloud-like patterns. And you're really seeing, just look at the pieces of brocade hanging on this wall. It's really extravagant, really elaborate, really sophisticated. So I said that this machine might be the king of all looms. This kind of weaving, brocade making, also might be the king of weaving because it's a very, very complicated technique. It takes two people just to operate this loom. And this is also from eastern China, from Nanjing, Nanking. If you're more familiar with this name, it's an ancient Chinese capital in the east. I'm going to see if we can find the craftsman here. I made him yesterday, so hopefully he can show us how to do this. 周老师, 我们来了, Mr. 周双喜, who is also a national level inheritor of the Yunjing, the cloud brocade making artist. 周老师，我们又来了。 We actually filmed Mr. Zhou the other day.
那个，您先给我们介绍一下这个云锦的这种技艺，可以吗？哦，这个云锦呢，它这个是在这个宋锦和蜀锦的这个基础上又往前发展了，而且发展了一个高度。直到现在呢，现代化机器呢，它无法取代它。
He said this is the culmination of the Chinese weaving art. And this ancient looking machine, to this day, no modern technology can replace it.
那这个织机好特别呀。这个织机呢，长是5.6米，高是4米。
4 meters high and 5.6 meters long.
它需要两个人操作，上面一个人。 在把这个，这个花它在上面叫提花，下面这个人呢就是叫织锦，就织造。
So like I said before, it takes two people just to operate this machine. 周老师今天有可能给我们展示一下吗？哦，马上叫那个，刚才看那个师傅在这儿啊。哎，先生。He's looking for his partner because like I said before, it takes two people, right? And so Mr. Zhou is looking for his partner here so that they can show us this very unique and difficult looking kind of craft. Mr. Zhou Shuangxi and his partner, 这位老师叫什么?
姓杨，叫杨建顺。
Mr. 杨建顺老师，谢谢您。 Wow, thank you so much for showing us this. This is really exciting. So basically, we're gonna just get a little taste of how this is made. you look at the stitches and you just don't see how this is possible. And if you look carefully, you can see there's gold threads in this. Like I said, this is a technique, the cloud brocade technique. It's used, it's adopted to make dresses for the royal court. And also in the Qing dynasty, in ancient dynasties, this is also a type of craft that's solely reserved for the royal family. So civilians are not, well, they couldn't afford, first of all, to buy brocades or dresses like this. And therefore, you don't care about the materials, you don't care about the time cost, you just make something that's awesome, basically. 啊，今天您不亲自上了，周老师？
我他们在表演啊，我呢有时候事多，他应该来问，应该来问。我晚上一次我他问了，我就没办法了。
Mr. Zhou is the national level inheritor of the arts. The other day when we came, we got really lucky as he personally showed us this cloud brocade making technique. But he said there are too many people here today and he has to answer their questions. Therefore, two of his colleagues are demonstrating for us the cloud brocade making process. We're seeing the first artist here. I'm not even sure if we should call them artists or craftsmen. I think both, right?And we're seeing another one up there. Like we said, the machine is 4 meters high. We're seeing a craftsman, a younger one, sitting on top of the machine, just unwinding the threads. I did a little research. I tried to comprehend how this machine actually works. So this is what I read, at least. So the craftsman on top should be in charge of pulling the strings.And the one on the bottom is responsible for weaving the patterns. But, and also, all of the patterns are actually pre-coded in the knots. I'm going to show you the knots just a little bit later as my cameraman has squatted down to film the weaving process.
Wow.
Oh, there's a piece of mirror down below, just to reflect. Wow. Oh, so pattern is, oh, 所以这个是反面。Oh, so you can actually see the patterns through the mirror, and it's on the bottom side. I didn't know about this the first day when I came here. This has just gotten more interesting for me. Wow.这个哎呀，我天哪，很难吧，老师？
很难的。
您做
了40年了。
Mr. Yang has been in this practice for more than 40 years now. And they told me the other day that it actually takes two artists a whole day just to produce 4 to 5 centimeters worth of cloud brocade.这个需要好细心啊！那您怎么知道这个应该？
根据它的图案走向。
哦。
根据走向。
图案在哪儿呢？
就是图案吗？你看这个，这个图案，图案在上面控制。
这个
都是图案。这个都是图案。
这个都是图案。He's telling me that this is pattern. I really don't get how, but he tells me that the pattern is already pre-coded.
上面把图案送下来。我把图案颜色，我负责把颜色织进去。
So the man on top sends down the pattern. That's what he said. Literal translation. I just think that's so poetic. And he's in charge of making it happen. 这个丝好细啊！
很细的，一根丝。
I just want to call your attention to how thin.
一点点。
我的天哪！
我都看不见。
哦。
一根。就是一根。
This is one strand of silk.
很细很细。
对，很费眼睛吧？
费眼睛。
It's very tiring for the eyes. Very tiring for the eyes. Mr. Yang just told me that they all have very They all have very bad eyes because this is such a task for the eyes.
Oh,
this is a gold string.
真是真金做的吗？
可以，也可以用真金，根据需要。
With real gold in it. So like we said, if you make something for the emperor, we can see gold. So coated gold, we can see gold on this side, and just plain material on this side. So we were saying, you know, this technique is adopted to make dresses for the kings and queens. So really, I'm not surprised that they put gold in it.
谢谢您，杨老师，我们去那边看看上面的那个师傅。
I just want to go take you to check out the artist, the craftsman on top. But first, just take a look at the crowd. I don't think we can go there anymore, so we're just gonna zoom in, and hopefully you can see what's going on top there. Even if you do see what's going on, I don't think you can understand what really is going on, because I don't. I know he's in charge of pulling the strings, and like Master Yang just told us, sent down the patterns, but I really don't get how, because they told me that the patterns are already pre-coded in, let me just tell my camera to, in these knots that you're seeing here, the masters just told me that the patterns are already pre-coded here by a separate artist. So you're like, what is going on here? This is, I have to say, I like this the most in this entire exhibition hall, because this is just so fascinating. And I just want to speak a few words with Mr. Zhou Shuangxi here.
周老师，您做这个有多少年了，才能成为一个国家级的这个传人？
我到现在已经做了46年。
So he's also been in this practice for 46 years.
就是什么让您坚持下来的？
怎么讲呢？就是一开始的时候呢，导师真不了解，后来做了以后，也就反正好像也离不开了，这么一辈子就做下来了。
He says when he first started doing this, he didn't know what this was all about, just like us. But then he continued because he fell in love with this art form, and he's been doing it for his entire life.
那您觉得这个技艺，您有信心把它传下去吗？
我是想多传，多教一些徒弟，但是呢，这个因为这个学习的周期太长，好多年轻人呢他耐不下来，缺乏的就是像我这种一做几十年这种，他没办法。有的人就是坚持不下来，一学了一半就走掉了，
But as a national level inheritor of the craft, he just expressed regret, because he's tasked with promoting and passing down this kind of art form, this kind of craft, and he says he's trying to train as many students as possible. But young people nowadays aren't like him anymore, who can dedicate it their whole lives, because the learning process is quite long. It takes years and years just to fine tune your craft. And he told me the other day that he's been in this business for 46 years and he still doesn't know everything about it. And he just expressed regret that he feels like young people nowadays can't sit down for years, even decades, to just do one thing and just fine tune, just perfect your techniques. And he's expressing the regret that he feels about the possibility of losing this kind of craft.
但是您现在还年轻嘛，其实还是可以再多带一
点。我已经64岁了。
He's already 64 years old.
那您现在徒弟有几个？就您觉得干的比较好的？
留了大概两三个徒弟。
He only has 2 to 3 students now.
所以还是心里有一定的那种危机感，怕那个。
对对对，就是说呢，就是学这个云锦，一定是要什么，就是心无旁骛的，就是要静下心来，啊，一直要能坚持。
So he said you have to be very down to earth, very dedicated, very, you can't think about it too many things, can't think about anything else, and you just have to dedicate your time and life into this kind of life form. And that's a kind of quality that we're seeing in a lot of the craftsmen from last generation. And I admit, as a younger person, that is a kind of a disadvantage of our generation because the world just has gotten so much more interesting. There are so many more distractions. And yes, it's true, we can't sit down anymore for a lifetime doing one thing. So I guess, yes, that's a shame, I guess.
周老师，谢谢您，谢谢。
Thank you so much, Mr. Zhou, for joining our show. And this is such a beautiful type of... And this is such a beautiful type of art form. So this whole place is cordoned off. I'm very grateful that these artists let us in, actually, to film. 谢谢您。谢谢谢谢。Visitors are actually helping us get out of the crowd. Like I said, a very friendly crowd. I guess it's because everyone's seeing so many beautiful pieces, and it's just very pleasing for your...for all of your sensations. Moving on, just a recap for those of you who just tuned in. You're watching CGTN and we're live for you in Jinan City in eastern China's Shandong province at a expo featuring China'sIntangible cultural heritage, and there are hundreds of them, and we're seeing thousands of items, hundreds of craftsmen. The venue appeals to your every sensation. There's tea making, alcohol making, and sadly we're not gonna have the time to go through everything. We are in this hall, which featuresWhich features the art of weaving. And I just want to take a tour to this stand because it just occurred to me that this is also weaving, and yet it's so different from the extravagant, sophisticated kind of weaving that we just saw at the previous stand. This is called grass weaving.Grass cloth. Just hold on one second, my cameraman lags behind. I lost him in the crowd. Here you are. 这个夏衣 in Chinese is called 夏衣夏布 I'm sorry, 夏布 which means summer cloth. It's made out of...the fibers of a particular plant called rami. The reason why it's called summer cloth is because of its breathable fabrics, which makes it suitable to wear in the summer. But because it's a type of natural fiber, the strands are also very fragile. So this is also very meticulous work.
大姐，我们又来了，能再给我们展示一下吗？哎呀，今天穿的好漂亮。
This husband and wife, this is husband and wife.
我们又来了。
And the husband just said, "You've come again." Yes, we've met a few days ago.So yes, they're going to show us the technique.
Thank you.
A little girl just said, "I also want to see it."
你也想看一下？
想看什么？
想看一下怎么操作的，这是吧？
想看那个。
跟阿姨说，
跟阿姨说，你觉得这个好玩吗？
She thinks this is interesting.
从来没有见过。
And her mom said she's never seen anything like this. 你几岁了？上几年级了？
九岁，上三年级。
啊
，third grader， 是本地人吗？是本地人吗？She's from here. She's gotten shy. So let's just watch how this is done. Wow. Is 这边天气太干了是吗？She said the weather here in Shandong province, in Jinan City, is too dry, which makes her work all the more difficult. She's from Sichuan, which is a very humid region in southwestern China. 是不是干了这个就容易断呀？啊，when the weather is too dry, then the strings that you're seeing here are easily breakable.So she has to be even more careful when she's weaving what we call summer cloth or grass cloth. And just look at this piece of protective material behind her waist. I was told the other day that this is a craft where you have to coordinate your waist, your feet, your hands, your eyes. You have to coordinate all these sensations and make them work in sync with one another. It's not very demanding on the body, but you'd have to be very meticulous and careful. So it's a lot of mind work. But just notice how this is so different from cloud brocade that we saw just earlier. Cloud brocade is for the royal court, it's from the emperors and empress. And this is really beauty in simplicity.This art form, I guess you cannot call it an art form yet when this technique started hundreds of years ago because it's really out of practicality. But looking at it now, you feel like it's a form of art and it's definitely beauty in simplicity. And let's just come here and take a tour at the...final product weaved out of grass cloth here. Oh, this is the
tool.
This is a tool that we saw just now in the lady's hand. It's made out of cow horn. And it has to come from a cow from a very specific kind of region. And I really like these fans. And these ones right here. So like I said,
下部则上这是两大非遗。这下部是非遗，也是国家级非遗。这是则上也是国家级非遗。
He says this is a combination of two intangible cultural heritages, as the summer cloth or grass cloth is one item in China's list of intangible cultural heritage, and this specific fan making technique, it's another.Intangible cultural heritage, and this is peony, I think, and this is lily. both flowers that carry symbolic significance in traditional Chinese culture. And we're seeing summer cloth or grass cloth bags here. So like I said, I think it's turned from a craft out of practicality to really a type of art form. And I think this kind of transformation is so important in the preservation of China's intangible cultural heritage, or the world's intangible cultural heritage in general. Just thanking the owners of the stand for showcasing us this wonderful type of art and the material that they use to make this art. We've been touring this venue for what, a little more than an hour now, and I feel like it's still the tip of the iceberg. There are just so many things to see, and it's just wonderful to see cloth or lanterns coming from different regions, taking on different colors, sizes, shapes, textures, patterns. I think that's the beauty in art. If you get to the bottom of it, I think these art forms all originated from the same necessities, or you can even say that to some extent they come from the same roots. Somebody told me the other day that the accumulation of fashion, because all you're seeing right now is what's the most fashionable of its time and place. So the accumulation of that kind of fashion is what makes culture, is what makes masterpieces. And I think that is just so well said. And we're also standing in ever-changing time and space to look at culture, look at art. This is why the theme of this year's Expo on China's intangible heritage is novelty and tradition, familiarity and strangeness. I think if you really think about it, every item of art is a combination of all of that: tradition, novelty, the old and the new, the strange and the familiar. And they're ever-changing, ever-morphing with the development of a culture, development of a society, of our world. Nothing is still, and nothing is right. And there's just endless possibilities. And I think that's what makes art so interesting and precious. With that, we come to the end of our show. You're watching CGTN. Goodbye from you, from Jinan City, Shandong Province. I'm Tao Yuan. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.